I've written a little bit of code here, and what I've done is I have in the D column or in the C column here, I have used data and data validation to enter values here. So on these products, they can, when they enter them, they can either suggest that they belong in the warehouse or the yard. And so I've dragged that down so that if you enter a new one, then it will be there for you. So what I've done is I have created a worksheet called warehouse, and I've created a worksheet called yard. Now, what I'm going to do is when I click this sort, it's going to click or sort all the items from this list into the two categories. Now, you have selected these categories, so you could be selecting anything you want. You could be selecting a month or something else, but it's by user selected categories is what these are going to be sorted into. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this and I'm going to go click on my sort button. And so now if we go to the warehouse, we have our two warehouse products. And if we go to the yard, we have our one yard product. So let me show you the code. So what I have done is I've called sort by selection, and I'm doing I equals 2 because I have heading rows, and I'm doing a do until I1, which is where the date is empty. Okay, and so if I2 is not equal to blank and cells I3 equals warehouse, then range is I1 to I2 copy, select the warehouse sheet, set found blank equals range, A equals A1 to A1000, it could be whatever, and find, we're looking for a blank, and look at the whole thing. And then found blank select, end row equals found blank row, active sheet cells end row 1 select, active sheet paste. And so it does the exactly same thing. If there's value in I2 and I3 equals yard, then it will do exactly the same thing as it's doing here. So I select my worksheet received so that it's not looking in one of my other two worksheets looking for an empty cell. And then I've increased I by 1, and then I'm looping. So there you go. That's how you sort items by categories selected by the user. Please subscribe.